There once was a time I snuck a chicken on a 5-hour flight across the US. Thinking about this gives me anxiety, and I'd probably never do it again. The story I'm gonna tell you should be considered alleged, for entertainment purposes only, an urban legend, a myth, whatever. But I will be performing it in first person as if it was my own story, but it's not. Just because I think it would be more fun. So in March 2020, I was babysitting my friend's chicken before we all went in lockdown, and we got stuck together for 5 months. There was a point where the family I was babysitting for decided to stay in the place that they were and live there full time indefinitely. So I needed to bring their chicken to where they lived, which was across the country. I didn't want to drive because that would take like 5 days, and everyone knows you can't bring a chicken on a plane, right? After reading a bunch of forums where everyone said no, like you can't bring a chicken on a plane, I decided to do more research with the particular airlines, and I found out there are 5 airlines that allow you to bring birds in the cabin with you. So here's the kind of language they use. According to their websites, these airlines describe their bird allowances as small household birds or domesticated birds. Some airlines explicitly list restrictions on large birds, such as parrots, macaws, cockatoos, and birds of prey. So here's how I determined that this particular bird fit the airline requirements. First of all, is she small? Yeah, she weighed 1 pound. The bird that I'm talking about is the same breed as Wren, so similar in size. Is she household? I mean, yeah, she lives in a house. She's an indoor pet chicken, and she's so domestic that she wears a diaper. As per the airline's rules, this bird qualified to fly in cabin. I could not find any language in their policies that prohibited me from bringing a chicken on a plane. But I was still nervous because I had like this internal knowledge that you can't bring a chicken on a plane. I don't know. I could not find anything on any airline's website. So I bought a ticket, and when I went to buy a ticket, it allowed you to add a pet. It didn't ask for the pet's breed. It didn't ask for any documentation about health and vaccination. Didn't ask you for the pet's name, nothing. I assume that's something that they would do when you got to the gate with your pet so that they could verify the information. That part was easy. I didn't have to interact with any humans when I was buying the ticket. I just had to pay a small fee to bring my pet onto the plane. But I was a little bit nervous about going through security and then the actual walking onto the plane with her. But before I do, I want to proactively address some of the questions that you might have. The first being, why didn't you just register as an ESA? First of all, she's not my bird. And second of all, the abuse of registering animals as emotional support animals has a negative effect on people who have service animals. They're not being taken seriously when these animals provide essential life tasks for them. And I didn't want to contribute to that in any way. So why didn't I call the airline to confirm? Listen, if an airline told me explicitly that they wouldn't allow chickens, I would be way more nervous to bring the chicken on the plane, and I probably would have just canceled the trip. I preferred to risk being denied boarding and then to just call them. I prepared this elaborate cover story. I was ready for like any question. So if they asked me about her breed, I was gonna say she was a mixed breed. And if they had a problem with that, I was gonna say, oh, well, that's not what Petco said when I got her from there. I don't even think they sell chickens at Petco. Also, I don't buy animals. Let's just say I was about to pretend to go against all of my values to get on this plane. You also might be wondering, why couldn't she just fly herself? For all the care that I gave her, she should be able to complete this one small task, but unfortunately, she couldn't carry the weight of pellets needed to fuel her flight. Going through TSA is stressful on a normal day when you have like no luggage. Now, going through TSA with plenty of luggage and an animal is extremely stressful. I knew that I couldn't go through the x-ray machine and that they would probably make me go through the metal detector instead and swipe me for explosive residue. I was expecting to be questioned. So I put my luggage on the belt, I take my shoes off, I'm standing there holding a chicken in my hand, trying to make eye contact with somebody from TSA and literally no one's paying attention to me. I was holding a chicken in the middle of the airport and no one was paying attention to me. I finally made eye contact with a TSA agent and they just said, go wait over there, like motioning toward the metal detector. Eventually somebody did let me through the metal detector and proceeded to swipe my hands for explosive residue. So the guy dusting my hands asked me, what is she? I love a vague question because I replied to him, a bird. He didn't push me on it, but I know for a fact that I did not answer his question. At this point, I'm still confused because I have now purchased a ticket and gone through TSA and nobody has inquired about the animal that I'm carrying. I thought TSA would verify that I was allowed to be bringing this bird on a plane, like that I paid for her, that I was allowed to be bringing her into the airport concourse and onto a plane. And nobody said a thing at this point. I thought that at the gate, then finally they would check my ticket to make sure I paid and verify that my animal is okay to fly, is in accordance with their policy. But when I got to the gate, they scanned my boarding pass and let me on. They didn't ask about the chicken. They didn't even like read my boarding pass to know that I had an animal with me at all. So I just went on the plane, put her under the seat in front of me. She was really well behaved the whole time and generally went unnoticed by all of the airline staff, all of the TSA agents, all of the people on the plane, and that was that. I can't guarantee that it would be easy doing it again, and I would probably be too nervous to do it with one of my own birds. That you find this interesting. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Just remember that this is totally a work of fiction and for entertainment purposes only.